You're gonna tear that thing to ribbons.
What could you have possibly ordered for $15,000?
Look, Nick was having everything imported from Italy, and that takes a lot of stamps. And once you figure in what you lose with a peso, forget about it. Look, I just need the money for this house or your mom will quit her bitching and moaning.
Absolutely not. I do not reward negative behavior.
Well, how do you think I feel about this? I've been sitting around waiting for my jaws to come in, and the next thing I know, Nick's flown to Goop with his cans. You'll get it all back once the gravy takes off. I got plenty of product. I just gotta, you know, push it.
Viola, could you get that, please?
Sorry, business.
Come on, Joe. I'll even put you on the labels. Oh.
Joe Beal.
Amanda? Gary Coleman here.
Mr. Coleman, can I call you back?
As it turns out, my daddy intuitions were right on track. Daddy is in a bit of a bind, and not the good kind, might I add.
My dearest son, Jackson, is turning 8 on Saturday, and a celebration is in order. I forgot this one's birthday last year, and
Mama Bear is not happy.
When were you looking to have the party?
Saturday, of course.
As in 2 days from now?
Nobody likes a belated birthday.
Sorry, sir, but we require at least a week's notice. Our company takes pride and attention to detail. Pulling together even a decent party in 2 days is impossible.
We'll pay extra, whatever you want.
Sorry, no bribes or exceptions.
We could be in cahoots for quite some time.
Just wait until bar mitzvah and quinceanera season come along.
Sorry, maybe we can help some other...
Hi, this is Joanna's secretary, and she has a terrible case of the Hershey squirt, so she's gonna have to call you back.
What's wrong with you? What's wrong with me?
There are more loose screws in that man's mind than there are in an IKEA furniture box.
So? Your dad is dying out there for money and you're gonna turn down Mormon Gadsby? The sauce means a lot to him. He hobbled all the way here.
I'm not enabling his stupidity.
That's what dads do, Joanna. They do stupid things. Take this Coleman guy up in his offer and charge him way above the normal rate. Seduce him with this jovial bells and whistles and up the rate each time and within 4, 10 years, we'll be rolling in it. Sauce and all. Maybe 15.
You know I want to slow things down here so that I can go to grad school and get my PhD in psych. I don't want to wait that long.
It's just a few years, Joanna. The man spent half his life raising you. Just give him the sauce.
Gravy. Clear up your schedule tomorrow morning. What's your plan?
Plan?
I can get you the money, but there needs to be a sure plan that this will sell.
Oh, I just have to frame it right. You know, I'm the king of that. Remember that fundraiser I did a while back?
The pub crawl for Alcoholics Anonymous?
It raised 5,000 bucks in a day.
And cost half of New Jersey to relapse.
Niche marketing. Oh. It will sell, Joe. Everybody loves Guy's Gravy.
Everybody?
Yeah. Well, maybe they don't know it yet, but... But you do, right?
I want to list 10 buyers by the end of the day. Prove to me this gravy will sell.
It will sell, Joe. Trust me.
No. Mom worked for her shore house. I worked for this. Now it's your turn. You better have Chef Boyardee on speed dial.
Hey, Nino, my boy, it's Guy Grosso here. Yeah, from the Prosciutto to Mug Club. Listen, I got a deal you're gonna wanna get in on. Well, you remember my gravy, right? What do you mean, acid reflux? You didn't go on soft on me.
I'm so glad we could resume our affairs.
Likewise.
You'll have to excuse this dump. It's my children's salon du jour. My office is being fumigated for cooties. I got the vaccine, but you can never be too sure.
Sure. I'm going to need you to fill out a list of your guests and any food allergies we should be concerned about before we order catering. We could potentially bring in some ponies, or a moon bounce.
We're thinking more along the lines of the Prohibition era.
The Prohibition era.
The mob, espionage, Al Capone, all that stuff. Jackson hacked into my HBO Go account to Boardwalk Empire. Now it's all he can talk about. It's even influenced his artwork. He's a doll, isn't he?
Mr. Coleman.
Carrie.
We want to give you a great party. We really do, but don't you think this will be a bit difficult to pull off? We need smart alternatives to work with, considering our time constraints.
I'm not paying extra for some banal popcorn party, you know.
It won't be. For example, my associate, Viola, is a great magician, character actress, and clown.
No! There will not be clowns at any party of mine. I have a terrible phobia. Tiny cars just aren't meant to fit that many people. It's not how the Lord intended it.
Sorry. I just assumed that because you have a picture of a clown.
It's not a clown, you boob. That's my father, Cary Coleman Sr., inventor of the footsie pajamas.
Oh. Sorry. Big fan. The feet just seal in all the warmth.
Do they? Or are they just mechanisms to control the leg hands from realizing their full expression?
Sorry. Back to the party. Mr. Coleman?
Carrie.
No, not for turkey or fruit. It's gravy, like with tomatoes. Could you make that stuff? I can't find it anymore. No, as you Americans got it all screwed up.
Joanna?
Where have you been? I've been calling all morning.
Stop, I just woke up.
We'll rise and shine. Thanks to you, we have a Freudian field day on our hands.
Oh, what?
Carrie got one look at your headshot and went into full freakout mode.
Ugh. People need to get over this whole clown phobia thing. We are people too.
This is worse than a phobia.
Much worse. We're dealing with some deep-seated emotional issues here.
Parents be crazy.
This is all your fault. If this guy doesn't
snap out of it, we can forget any parties, let alone $15,000 worth.
You're the psych major, you fix him.
Sure. That will go over just beautifully.
Sorry, Jackson. We didn't plan you a party, but your daddy's father issues are all
under control.
Let me do it.
What?
Plan the party. I can do it.
You already
have a lot on your plate. I just need you to send me pictures of all the documents in my book.
Joanna, I get it. You're the brains of this operation. Sometimes I feel like you're objectifying me. Like
I'm just this pretty face for you
to whore around town.
That's not true. Our talents are just different.
I can never do what you do.
And I can never do what you do.
The brain voodoo that you do. Unless...
Unless what?
Unless you can't do it.
Of course I can do it.
Then do it.
Fine.
Party's all yours. It's for 12 kids. The theme is Prohibition. A espionage, Al Capone.
Are you speaking English?
Forget it. I'll text you the details. You can do whatever you want, but please stick to the contacts in my book. Use our caterers, seating charts.
Everything. And whatever you do,
no clown.
Clownist.
Don't make me regret this, bozo.
Showtime.
Wait, Joanna? Oh. Joanna?